You know, we live in the future when you can ask AI for any 3D model, process it in less than 15 minutes, and finally end up with this result that you can 3D print but also use in your videos, games, or anything else for free. Today we will talk about the Meshy AI, a tool for 3D artists that is capable of creating 3D models just from text, generating stylized textures of your own models, and also converting 2D images into 3D objects. Oh, and did I mention the ability to edit textures with eraser-like feature? The developers themselves seem to be very confident about their project, so let's put it to the test. Now, how does it work? At first, we need to create an account, which is a free process that lasts about a minute. Find Start for Free button in the upper corner of the homepage and create an account with your email. After completing that, we are welcomed by the Discover page, where you can find models shared by the community. The models are labeled, so you can easily swap between topics. Wait, does it mean all the models created here are automatically shared with everyone? Of course not. You have to make it public manually, but more on that later. To navigate the website, we use panel accessible on the left. From the top, you will find the Discover tab and then My Assets. All your models will be accessible here and they already come divided into groups based on the method you used to generate them. And then there are tutorials which will help you achieve better and better results. And now let's generate some 3D models. Currently, there are 4 different AI tools available, and we will begin with my personal favorite, which is a text-to-3D feature. To use it, all we need is to simply describe a 3D model we want to have. It could be something basic, like a wolf or a yellow elephant, for example, or it could actually be something very specific, like this steampunk plague doctor mask with rich floral ornaments. And this is what I absolutely love about this feature. As you've seen in my previous videos, I've tested a lot of text-to-3D AIs, and they usually work with simple objects, like a rubber duck, a race car, and such. But with Meshy, we can go for an absolute abstraction, and it will keep up the pace. Just look at some of those prompts. The author basically spilled their thought process here. We got some loose ideas like male fighter character, panda, cartoonish Zelda style, and so on. And even with this chaotic description, the AI produced a valid concept of a 3D model. That means you can effectively use it as a concept art tool for your games or videos. Just type whatever you have in mind and let the AI propose the outcome for your character. After you type in your prompt, you can check the negative prompt box to type in the things you don't want to see in your model, like avoid a certain color or a feature. Then you get to choose between the art styles, which are quite intuitive. Let's use the plague mask with floral ornaments for comparison. The realistic style comes with nice colors and details, while the sculpture mode is filled with tons of sculpted ornaments. The cartoon style resembles the video game or animation prop. And the low poly is, well, low poly. Now, let's finish our model. Click the Generate button and your object will be added to the wall of your projects. After several minutes, you will receive 4 generated drafts. Those are only a very simplified versions of your model that will slightly differ from one to another. Your job is to choose the one that looks the most accurate to your request. Don't look for the details here, focus on the overall shape. Like when I asked for this plague mask, you can see there are no ornaments visible yet, but the shape differs from the whole helmet to a beak and goggles only. Once you have your favorite draft chosen, click on Settings and pick the highest texture richness available, and then click on Refine. This will generate a detailed object with details matching your description. If you have more than one active project, simply scroll up or down to navigate between them. When you select a model, you can easily investigate it with mouse buttons. What's cool is that you can already see the number of vertices and faces. Those statistics are available here, in the display settings, much like the autospin feature. Above display settings, you can find wireframe mode and also disable texture visibility. Now, if you want to 3D print the model, you are probably alarmed at this point, because most of the details are only within the texture, so how am I gonna print it? Not to worry here, because we are going to transfer those texture details into the geometry, just like in this example. See? But before that, I want to show you yet another incredible feature. If you decide to upgrade to Pro version, you will get access to AI Texture Editing, a tool that works like an eraser for small errors. And it's incredibly handful. Simply select all the areas that look weird and describe what you want to see instead. Again, AI will generate few drafts for you to choose from. Once you pick your favorite, another model will be generated and added next to the original one. Basically, you can fix any accident without losing the entire model, and I absolutely love that. You can also make the model public for a chance to win free credits, but until you publish it, the model is only accessible to you. Just keep in mind, the models generated with free subscription fall under a Creative Commons license. And last but not least, you can download the 3D model and textures in variety of formats, including OBJ, STL, and even Blender file. Now, especially if you want to 3D print the model, I highly recommend downloading the Blender file, because in a minute I will show you how to transfer all the crispy details from texture to 3D geometry, so we can actually print what you see. But first, let me jump back to the Discover tab for a minute, so I can show you something cool. As you can see, to download a publicly shared model, you need a Pro version. However, we are being smart today. So instead, I'm gonna click on the model, copy the prompt, and then use it to generate this similar model myself. Downloading models is free as long as you're the author, so we are about to become one. A bit of patience and voilà. Le portrait de Jules Vernet is now ready to download with free account. Okay, that was the hack. Now let's talk about image to 3D feature. It's actually very simple. All you need is to select an image of your choice, give the project a name, and click Generate. Now, generating models from an image has and always will have its limitations, because there is a limited amount of information that AI can get from 2D photo. To get the best results, it's better to stick to the old rules, which you can actually find here. The rules are: choose images with a single object rather than a group of different things, go for the front view images, avoid tilted poses and perspective, and use images with plain background so the object stands out clearly. The rest works basically the same as with the previous tool, so let's move on to AI texturing. And this is something I haven't seen before. What this feature does is generate a stylized textures for your own models. You need to create a new project and name it, and then upload the model you want to work with. Next, briefly describe what it is, and provide the request for what you want your texture to look like. Again, there are great art styles available, and I encourage you to experiment with them all. In just a few minutes, you can get a custom texture tailored to your request. You can also switch to PBR shading and adjust some settings, which is another cool addition. Now, this feature is amazing for game developers, animators, or concept artists, but it's also incredibly useful for 3D printing enthusiasts. Like I said, we can already transfer details from texture to geometry, So, starting with this basic magic stuff, or magic blob as I would say, I can easily generate this beautiful detailed texture and turn it into an actual detailed model for printing. And it took me like 3 minutes to get from this to that. How cool is that? Okay, but I want to show you how to turn those models into 3D prints already. After you download the blend file, open it in Blender, which is a free and powerful software. It will contain your model and assigned texture. Now, I'm about to quickly show you how to transfer texture details to geometry, but if you need a precise step-by-step explanation, you can find a perfect beginner tutorial on my channel, right here. At first, we need to add more geometry, so I will open a modifiers tab and search for subdivision surface. Keep it on low level for now, so it doesn't get heavy too soon. Now we will add the displace modifier. Trust the process here, the mess you see is absolutely normal. Now click new to create new texture and let's go to the texture tab over here. Blender is now ready to distort our model in a certain way and we will use the texture as a sort of a manual for the distortion shape. If you have your texture downloaded, you can find it here, but since we downloaded a blend file with model and texture already included, I will just click here and use this one. Now go back to modifiers and turn down displacement strength extremely low, like 0.01. Then change coordinates from local to UV. What's missing now is the fine geometry, which will allow Blender for more accurate displacement. Find subdivision modifier and one by one increase levels in the viewport. This part is extremely satisfying, but don't go too far because heavier geometry may crush your session. Once you're done, apply all modifiers and that's it. You can now export your model in STL format and open it in any slicer to 3D print. Now, when you know this magic trick, you can start with any model and generate any texture or many textures to add insane details for printing. And with Meshy's capabilities, it means even the fine sculptures can be generated, downloaded and edited in a couple of minutes. While all that can be done for free, Meshy, like many other sites, run on the policy of credits. Each generated model, texture, refining process, etc. cost credits. With a free account, you get 200 credits per month, which will give you quite a lot of results and fun, plus you can earn free credits for sharing models with the community. However, if you want to have access to texture editing, faster processing, 1000 credits a month and other benefits, you can consider getting a pro subscription. Currently, new users get 50% discount on their first purchase and you can check on the homepage if this deal is still valid when you watch this video. And now, I want to thank the Meshy AI team for asking me to put their website to the test. And while this video is in fact sponsored by Meshy AI, I have made it very clear I'm remaining unbiased to give you my honest review about this project. And I am honest when I say I'm simply amazed with the features you have seen today. Of course, not every attempt will be instantly successful, sometimes there are errors or failures. But it doesn't change the fact that 3D modeling AI is no longer just a fun curiosity. It is becoming a game changer, a tool that can be used in a professional workflow. And when we get even beyond that, I will be the first to deliver the news to you. I really hope you enjoyed the video and if you did, consider subscribing to my channel. Thank you for watching.